Hello and good morning everyone. Welcome back once again in English video, and today in this video we are going to take a new chapter from your another book of literature, that is Honeysuckle, and this is the chapter number 7 from this book. The chapter name is Fair Play, and this worksheet is worksheet number 43 that you are going to do in this video and worksheet. Now let us start this chapter, Fair Play. Now children, this Fair Play is a play. It's a kind of a play. You all know act is a kind of act, and it is divided into 3 parts. Today we are going to do only 2 parts in this video because it is a very lengthy chapter. So I'll be going to give you explanation of this chapter in parts. All right. So and also in your worksheets, the exercise which I have given to you is word meanings. Word meanings and also some of the question and answers, and one more exercise is there, who said to whom and why, from your book only. And the questions I have covered in this worksheet today, which you will be writing in your notebooks, are taken from only that part which I am going to explain you today. All right, it means that the exercises I have taken, the word meanings are from the whole chapter, but the exercises which I have given in your worksheet is from the part which I have explained, that is the part 1 and part 2. Okay, so let's start. So now before you read, as I have told you, this is your chapter name Fair Play and chapter number 7 from your book Honeysuckle. Now before you read, has your best friend ever done something you thought was wrong? That what did you do then? Did you keep quiet or did you tell your friend what you thought? Now this is a story, or you can say a play, based on two friends, very best friends. They were two very best friends, and this the introduction part is also asking you that has your best friend, any one of your best friend, has done something that you thought it was wrong, and did you tell him that he was wrong or right? So this is story about those friends. Okay, now let's read this chapter. I don't have book, so I'm just writing, reading from my another phone, and I have downloaded the PDF. And you can also do like this, that if you don't have any book, NCERT books are available online, and you can easily download their PDF in your phones, and then you can read the chapters. So let's start Fair Play. Part 1. I'm starting from part 1. First is, Juman Sheikh and Algu Chaudhary were good friends. So strong was their bond of friendship that when either of them went away from the village, one another looked after his family. Both were greatly respected in the village. Now the characters, main characters of this play, are two best friends whose name were Juman Sheikh and Algu Chaudhary. Now these both the boys guys were very best friends. They were very good friends, and their bond was very strong. Their bond was so strong that that bond of friendship I'm talking about, that the bond of friendship was so strong that either one of them go away from out of the village, they both looked after their families. Means they were having a very good friendship, a very good bond, that they were very in a very good relationship with their families also. Okay, so and for this only, because they had a very great bond, they looked after the families also. So they both were very respectful in the village. All the people of the village respected them and also their bond of friendship. Now, Juman had an old aunt who had some property. This she transferred to him on the understanding that she would stay with him and he would look after her. The arrangement worked well for a couple of years. Now what happened, Juman, one of those friends, Juman, had an old aunt. He had an old aunt who had some property. Property means some kind of a piece of land, house and whatever. All right, property means. So she had some property, and that she transferred her property to Juman, in the name of Juman, because she was not having any child. She was didn't have any family. So she transferred her whole property to Juman in the understanding. What the understanding? Understanding means you can say she compromised with Juman that, okay, I will give you my property. I am handing my property to you, to Juman, and he will take care of that old aunt thereafter. All right. Now, what happened? The arrangement worked well for a couple of years. That arrangement that Juman and aunt made, that she would be giving her property to him and he will be taking care of her after that. This arrangement was well for the couple of years, for few years. Couple of years means 1 or 2 years, or you can say for few years. Then the situation changed. Juman and his family were tired of the old relative. Juman became as indifferent to her as his wife. Now, what happened? After a couple of years, they took care of her. But after a couple of years, the situation changed. And what did the situation was that Juman and his family were tired of the old relative. Means that they did not want to take care of that old aunt anymore. And Juman also and his wife both became indifferent. Now, what does this indifferent means? Indifferent means that they lost their interest of taking care of their aunt. Okay, so they do not want to take care of their aunt. So the both husband and wife, that means Juman and his wife, became indifferent to her, towards their aunt, who grudged even the little food that the old lady wanted every day. Now they were so much indifferent, they became so much indifferent to that aunt that his wife, Juman's wife, grudged even to give a little food or three times of food to that aunt. What do you mean by grudged? Now here a word grudged means that to give unwillingly, that she didn't want to give anything to her for eating, or it means overall it means that they did not want to take care of her now. Okay, take care of her means giving food, okay, shelter she was having, but basically giving food. They did not want to give her food. So how much an old person eats? Hardly one chapati or two chapati. All right, but she did not want to give that little food also to that old aunt. Now, she swallowed these insults along with her food for a few months. Okay, now what happened that whenever she, Juman's wife, gave food to that aunt, she was always insulting her aunt. Okay, she was always she didn't give her food very lovingly, or did not talk to her very politely. This was very, very insulting for aunt. Okay, so she swallowed this insult. Swallowed these insults means she tolerated them. She tolerated them, whatever behavior they showed to her, what tantrum they showed to her, she tolerated. Now, for the few months she tolerated, but patience has its limit. What does this mean? But patience has its limits. It means that she was tolerating and she was not able to tolerate that anymore at all. Okay, now it was limitless. It was beyond her limits now. So next page is, now one day she spoke to Juman. "My son, it is now obvious that I am not wanted in your house. Kindly give me a monthly allowance so that I can set up a separate kitchen." So now what happened? One day, when she was tired of tolerating that insult that both husband and wife gave to her, she spoke to Juman that, "My son," she spoke very politely, "that now it is very obvious." Obvious means O-B-V-I-O-U-S. Obvious means that it's very clear and it is very easily understood. Okay, that I am not wanted in your house. That she said that I think I am not wanted in your house anymore, because as they were behaving with her, it was very clear and obvious. So she said that now kindly give me monthly allowance. Monthly allowance means that she wanted monthly some kind of money, and she wanted to set up a separate kitchen for herself. That means she wanted to cook food for herself, because she was very much confident. She was very much clear about that Juman and his wife didn't want to give food to her. So she said, because all her property now belonged to Juman, so she said that okay, I have given you all my property, I have my named my all property to you. Now you can give me monthly allowance. It means monthly some money to me, that's so that I can set up a separate kitchen and I can cook food for myself. Okay, she told this to Juman. She told this very politely. Now, next, my wife knows best how to run the house. Be patient, said Juman shamelessly. This made his aunt very angry, and she decided to take her case to the village panchayat. Now, what was the reply after Juman's aunt asked Juman to ask Juman for the monthly allowance? What was his reply? What was his reaction? Juman's reaction. He said that his wife knows best. She's his wife is best and knows how to run the house. Okay, so be patient. And this he said very shamelessly, because he was supporting his wife. She was not taking care of that old lady, and whose property they were occupying. Okay, and then also he was not willing to give any monthly allowance or money to her. So it was very shameful for Juman, but he said this very shamelessly. Now, after hearing this his reaction, after hearing his response, aunt was very angry, and she decided to take this case to the village panchayat. Okay, now you all know that what is village panchayat. In the older days, now in these times there are courts where some these kind of issues go for the judgment, but in the earlier times and the older times there were village panchayats. Okay, so there were five panch as a head, and they took all the decision. They heard the both sides, what was the issue, and then they took the decision. Okay, now so she decided to take her case to the village panchayat. For many days, the old lady was seen talking to the villagers, explaining her case and seeking their support. Some sympathized with her, others laughed at her, and a few others advised her to make it up with her nephew and his wife. Now, what happened after she thought that she would be taking the case in front of the village panchayat? After that, for many days, what did that old lady do? She was explaining her case, she was talking about her case to other villagers also, so that she could seek their support, she could seek their idea, or you can say she could take advice also. Seek means to looking for the support and advice. Okay, some sympathized her. Sympathized means that they expressed the sympathy towards her, or you can say pity. So some sympathized her, and some of them laughed at her. Okay, some of them laughed at her also, and few others advised her. What advised others? Some of the people gave her that make up with her nephew and his wife. Okay, they advised like her like this. Now, what does this phrase means? Make it up. Make it up means to stop quarreling and make some agreement, a kind of a thing, or you can say compromising. Okay, so there were three types of advices she seeked, like she was seeking for the support, religious support, but some of them sympathized her, some of them laughed at her, and some of them said that she should make it up with her nephew, or you can say she should compromise with her nephew and his wife. At last she came to Algu Chaudhary and spoke to him. "You know, Chachi, Jumman is my best friend. How can I go against him?" Algu said. Now at last, after when she was all not satisfied with the suggestions and the advices of the villagers, at last she came up to Algu Chaudhary, okay, and she spoke to him about this matter. Now what was Algu's reaction? Algu said that, "Chachi, you know that Jumman is my best friend, and how can I go against him?" All right, now everyone does like this, that whenever your friend is involved in any case, any kind of a case, if he is wrong or right, you will always support him or her. Okay, so the first thing that came to Algu's mind was that whether he is right or wrong, he cannot go against him because he was his best friend. So he told this clearly to Chachi, that how can he go against his best friend. Now, "But it is right, my son, to keep mum and not say what you consider just and fair," pleaded the old lady. Now what did old lady said after this? When Algu said that how can I go against my best friend, the old lady, the aunt, said that, "But it is right, my son, to keep mum and not say what you consider just and fair." Now she said that, "My son, is it right? Is it right to keep quiet?" Mum means, M-U-M, mum means to keep quiet or to be silent. Okay, so she said that, "My son, that is it right? Is it good to keep quiet and not say anything? If you feel that something is is not fair or something is going wrong, it is good to keep shut, or good to keep silent," pleaded the old lady. Now consider means that to think carefully about something. Okay, consider means to think carefully about something. So she said that if you think that something is going wrong or something is getting to the wrong direction, is it correct to keep it quiet? Pleaded means to beg or to request. She requested to Algu Chaudhary, "Come to the panchayat and speak the truth," she said. Now she also requested Algu to come to the panchayat and speak the truth. Why did she wanted to Algu to speak the truth? She wanted to him to support her. Okay, she wanted Algu to speak in support of her and go against Jumman, because because he knew that Jumman was wrong. Algu didn't reply, but her words kept ringing in her ears. Now after listening to this old lady aunt, he didn't reply anything, but what did she say after hearing her, that you should not keep mum if you think that something is going wrong. You should not keep mum, it's not right. So she wanted him to support her in front of panchayat. She wanted him to speak the truth in front of the panchayat. So all this thing was ringing in his ears means it was all going into his head all the time. Now here your first part ends, the first part of a play, fair play, ends. Now let's start the second part. The panchayat was held the same evening under an old banyan tree. Jumman stood up and said, "The voice of Panch is the voice of God." Now that evening, the same evening means that evening when old lady or the aunt went to Algu Chaudhary and all that conversation happened, that same evening the panchayat was held, and it was held under an old banyan tree. Earlier days, whenever the panchayat was held, it was under a very old banyan tree or any other big tree, big shady tree. Okay, so this panchayat was also held under a big old banyan tree. Now Juman stood up and said, "The voice of Panch is the voice of God." Now when everybody was gathered for that matter, for resolving this matter, this case, Juman stood up and said that the voice of Panch is the voice of God. It means whatever the Panch will decide will be decided and will be taken it that the God has decided. Okay, because the Panch is always right. Now you can see in the picture there is a very big tree, a very big shady tree, and under that tree many people are sitting. You can see here, if it is clearly visible, you can see here Aunt, okay, Algu and Juman and other people of that village are also sitting. Okay, now Aunt nominate the head Panch. I will abide by her decision. Now what does Juman says? Juman says that Aunt should nominate the head Panch. Now it was a rule that the person who came up in the Panch with the along with their matter or along with their case, they were given an opportunity to nominate the head Panch. Okay, there were Panch means five members in the group who decided their matter, who decided the case, and among them there was a main head Panch, one head Panch who was the head of that group. Okay, so Aunt was given an opportunity, basically Juman gave an opportunity to Aunt that she should decide. Nominate means to decide or to propose or to suggest some name or suggest the name to be the head Panch for someone. Okay, so he said that Aunt, I'm giving Aunt an opportunity that she can decide the head Panch. She can nominate the head Panch. Whosoever she wants to nominate, she can nominate. I will abide by her decision. He says, whosoever she will decide or nominate as a Panch, I will abide by her decision. Abide means accept. He will accept her decision, that he will not go against the decision that this person is head, will be head or not. Okay, so he will be abide by her decision, whatever decision she will take about the head Panch. This opportunity or this was given to Aunt. Now next, the Panch knows neither friend nor enemy. What do you say to Algu Chaudhary? The old lady announced. Now after this, when old lady, that aunt, was given an opportunity to decide to nominate or to propose the name of head Panch, she proposed the name of whose name? Algu Chaudhary. What did she say? She say that Panch knows neither friend nor enemy, that the person who sits on the chair, who sits on the place of head Panch, who sits on this position, he does not know any friend or enemy. She means that everybody is equal in the eye of Panch. All right, so she announces, after saying this, she announces the name of Algu Chaudhary. Fine, replied Juman, hiding his joy over his unexpected piece of luck. Now as the aunt announced the name of Algu Chaudhary, Juman was very happy. He said fine, and he was very happy from within. He was very happy from inside. He was hiding his joy. Joy means happiness. Okay, he was hiding his happiness. He was hiding his joy as soon as he heard the name of head Panch as Algu, his best friend. He was very happy with this. Why? Because he knew that Algu Chaudhary was his best friend and he will take the decision. He expected that he will take the decision for Juman, for him. Okay, now next. Chachi, you are aware of my friendship with Juman, said Algu. Now as soon as he Chachi, or you can say old lady, nominated Algu's name, Algu said that चाची यू आर अवेयर, अवेयर मीन्स यू नो दैट जुम्मन एंड आई आर बेस्ट फ्रेंड्स, यू नो दैट हाउ द बॉन्ड ऑफ आर फ्रेंडशिप इज, ओके. I know that, replied the aunt, but I also know that you will not kill your conscience for the sake of friendship. Now, when Algu said that, Chachi, you are aware of our friendship, Chachi said, or that aunt replied, that I know that. I know that you both are very best friends, you both are very good friends, and you share a very good bond. Okay, but I also know this, that you will not kill your conscience. Conscience means a person's moral sense, you can say, a person's moral sense or a person's thinking about what is right and what is wrong. Okay, so she said that I don't think so that because of your friendship, you will kill your conscience, you will kill your moral values for your friendship. God lives in the heart of Panch and his voice is the voice of God. And the old lady explained her case. Now, after saying this, after telling Algu Chaudhary that I know that he and Jumman were very best friends, she knows that, and she said that I also know this, that he will not kill his conscience, he will not go against his moral values for his friendship. And she also said that God lives in the heart of Panch, so whatever the decision the Panch will take, okay, it will be the voice of God. Now, after saying this, she explains her case in front of everybody and also in front of the Panch. Now, next, Jumman said Algu, you and I are old friends. Your aunt is as dear to me as you. Now, I am a Panch. You and your aunt are equal before me. What have you to say in your defense? Now, after sitting in the place on the chair of Head Panch, Algu said to Jumman, that Jumman, that you and I are very best friends, very old friends, and also your aunt, as it was also explained earlier in the chapter, that whenever the one of either of them went away from the village or out of the village, they both they take care of their families also. So he said that your aunt is also dear to me as you are dear to me. And when now I am a head punch, and you both, your aunt and you, are equal in front of me. Okay, now tell me what he has to say in his defense. Defense means in protection, or you can say to protect himself, what he wants to say, or some kind of thing that he could support. He could say in support of his matter. Okay, because aunt had explained her case in front of the villagers, so he wanted to know that what Jumman has to say in his defense. 3 years ago began Jumman. Now Jumman began his story that 3 years ago my aunt transferred her property to me. I promised to support her as long as she lived. I have done all I could. There have been a couple of quarrels between my wife and her, but I can't stop it. Now my aunt is claiming a monthly allowance from me. This is not possible. That's all I have to say. Now, what does he say? What does Jumman says? That he starts from the very beginning, that 3 years ago, what happened? That his aunt transferred property for him to him. His aunt transferred her all property to him, and also I promised her, that means Jumman promised her, his aunt, that he will be taking care of his aunt as long as she lives. Okay. It means throughout her life, they will take care of. But what happened that some of the matters were like that his wife and aunt had a couple of quarrel happened between aunt and his wife. So he said that I could not stop it. I could not control that quarreling. And now aunt is claiming monthly allowance or monthly money. So that is not possible for me. I can't pay her money. Monthly payment I can't give her. And I cannot say anything else. Okay, so this was all he said in support of his case. Now next, Jumman was cross-examined by Algu and others. Now only Algu was not as the head punch. There were four other members in the group. Algu was the head. Main punch was Algu. And then when after listening to Aunt also, Aunt's case and also whatever Jumman said to defend him, Jumman was cross-examined with the Algu and others. Cross-examined means his side was discussed about between Algu and other judges. Then Algu announced, "We have gone into the matter carefully. In our opinion, Jumman must pay his aunt a monthly allowance or else the property goes back to her." Now, after cross-examining Jumman and their case, Algu announced, after discussing amongst other people in the group, he announced that "we have gone into the matter carefully," that he said that "we have seen and we have discussed about this whole matter and everything and properly, very carefully, and in our opinion." It means it was not only Algu's opinion, it was other members of that panchayat also, that Jumman must pay his aunt a monthly allowance, or you can say monthly payment he should give to her, or else. There were two options for Jumman, that he must give the monthly money to his aunt, or else what he will do, he will give all the property back to his aunt. Now the two friends were seldom seen together. Now after this, the case was solved. Okay, case was resolved and the judgment, or you can say verdict, was given by Algu, okay, against Jumman, which says that he must give allowance to aunt or else he should return her property back to her. So after this, the case was dismissed, the court was that panchayat was adjourned. And after that, the both friends were seen seldom. Seldom means they were hardly seen. They were very, because earlier they were so best friends that wherever they go, they went together. Okay, but after this, they both got separated. Okay, and they were hardly seen together. The bond of friendship between them was broken. Now, because Algu gave verdict against Jumman, their bond of friendship, their old bond of friendship, was broken now. In fact, Jumman was Algu's enemy and wanted his revenge. Now, after this, Jumman was very upset with Algu, and because he was not expecting this kind of a verdict, or you can say this kind of a judgment against himself by his best friend. So he was very upset, angry with Algu, and he was full of revenge. He wanted to take revenge from Algu. Okay, now revenge means that some kind of action you want to take, or some kind of action to harm somebody, okay, who has done something wrong to you in your opinion. Okay, so you also want to do something wrong to them, or to take revenge. So this was I hope you have understood the chapter till here. It is a very interesting, and it is also a very very good play to read and also to understand and to get something out of it. It is a very nice play you can read, and also you can read this third part also till I come with another video of explanation. Alright, so this was your first part and second part. I have completed your explanation, and in today's worksheet, all the written work, half of the written work I have given you. I have given the question and answers in your worksheets only this time. I am not, I will be explaining your questions, but I am not dictating answers in the video because it's a very lengthy worksheet today. Okay, so I'll be reading the question and explaining the answers to you. So In the next video, we will be doing the third part, third explanation of third part of this play. Now this, I forgot to tell you the writer of this play. It is written by Premchand. Okay, Fair Play is written by Premchand. Now let's start the exercise. Now this is your worksheet. Here it is, your worksheet. And this worksheet is your number 43. Okay, this will be submitted, and you have to submit it on 20/10/2020. Now, as you will start doing a work, put, as you always do, put worksheet number, date, day, lesson name, and also you will not forget to put the book name, because you are having two books. So whenever you will preparing for your exams, you can get confused about what about the chapter from which book they are. Okay, so that's why I always tell you, I always insist in writing the book name under your chapter name. All right, this is the chapter number 7 from Honeysuckle. So some of the chapters are have been cut also, so no need to put the chapter number, just put the chapter name, but surely put the book name also. Now this is your exercise 1, and the first exercise is your word meanings, and the word meanings I have taken from the whole of the chapter. Okay, so first is indifferent. Some of the words and meanings I have taken from your book only. It is given in the side, right hand side of your chapters. Okay, and some of the words I have taken from the chapter, in within the chapter, from middle of the chapter, and I have given you the meanings also, because there are very less word meanings in your book. So first is indifferent. Indifferent means lost interest. Second is grudged. It means felt angry or unhappy about giving. Swallowed, these insults, means tolerated. Now there are some words and there are some phrases also whose meaning you have to give. Okay, so phrases, you all know what are words and what are phrases. You should know the difference between words and phrases. Word means one word, you can see here, and phrase means there are the group of words. Okay, they have some meaning, but they don't give you complete meaning, they don't give you the complete sense. Okay, they are not known as complete sense. Group of words means complete, a group of word means sentence, but when they become sentence, a group of words become sentence when they give complete meaning and are arranged properly. Phrases are also a group of words. They might be two words or three words or four words or more than that also, but basically mainly there are two, three words, four words in phrase, and they give us partial meaning. We cannot understand the whole thing, or we cannot understand the whole sentence with the phrase. Okay, so phrase are like these. There are the group of words, certain words, and they give us partial meaning, so they have some meaning. So here there are some phrases used in this chapter for which I have given you the meaning. So first phrase is swallowed these insults. Okay, so it means tolerated them. Fourth is obvious, clear, easily understood. Obvious means anything which is very clear to you, which is which you know what is exactly, and or you can say which is easily understood. So it's obvious. Okay, next is shamelessly. Shamelessly means without feeling shame. Sixth is sympathized. Sympathized means express sympathy or pity. Next is make it up, stop quarreling or to compromise. Eighth is consider, to think carefully about something. I told you consider means to think carefully about something. Okay, pleaded means to beg or to request or to make an emotional appeal. Now in the question in your book, pleaded means you can say make an emotional appeal, as aunt made to Algu to give his to go with the truth or to support her because she was right. Okay, so she was just she went to Algu to just seek his support because she was right. So at last she made an emotional appeal, or you can say she pleaded to Algu. 10th is mum. Mum means quiet or silent. 11th is nominate, to propose, to suggest. 12th is abide by, it means accepted. 13th, consigns, a person's moral sense of right or wrong. Defense means to protect or support. Claiming, to say that one has owned or earned something. Okay. Seldom means rarely, or you can see hard. You can say hardly also. I have not written that word, but you can say hardly. Tight spot. Tight spot means difficult situation. Okay. Dignity, it means state of honor or respect. Revenge, the action of harming or hurting someone in return of an injury or wrong done by them. Embrace. Embrace means to give a hug, or you can say it, hold closely in one's arm. When you hug somebody, it means you are embracing somebody. Okay. To put your arms around somebody means to embrace. 21st is deviate. It means to remove away from. Okay. To go away from. Now, next exercise is your exercise number 2. And this is your exercise from your NCERT book only, Honeysuckle book only. But this exercise number 2, this is first part of this exercise. Why? Because I have given you first part, because only those questions I have taken in this exercise, which are till your chapter I have explained. Okay, so 3 questions are from the part which I have explained. Same as your question answers also, I have given the first part of those question answers, which I have explained you from the part which I have explained you. I have taken those question answers only. Rest we will do after the explanation of the other part. Okay. So first is who said to whom and why. Now you always do the question who said to whom, but you don't do why. So this, in this exercise, you will also give the reason why the first person said these lines to another person. Okay. So first you have to give who said to whom answer, and then why. My wife knows best how to run a house. Now, who said this line? Juman speaks these words to his aunt. Why? Because he wanted to get rid of his aunt and did not want to give her any allowance. Okay? Because he did not want to keep his aunt anymore in their house. So, when she asked for the monthly allowance to him, he said that my wife knows best how to run a house. You don't worry about that. So next is, but it is right, my son, to keep mum and not say what you consider just and fair. Who said this? The old aunt says these words to Algu. Why? Why she says this? Because Algu was not willing to give his judgment against his best friend. Now, when did she say this? She said that when she went to Algu to seek his support, he told her case to him. He explained her case to him, and he said that, aunt, you know that we both are very good friends, very best friends, and I will not give any decision against him. I cannot go against him. So then she said that it is not good that, or you can say, she said that, is it good to keep quiet if you know something is going wrong? Okay, so this was said by aunt. Third is, what you have to say in your defense. Who said this? Algu said these words to Juman when he occupied the seat of head of the punch, and he also was very keen to do justice. So he asks Juman's point also. Okay. Now the exercise number 3 is your question and answer. Answer the following question. These are also from your book only, and only this is part 1 of question and answers. The first question is, then the situation changed. What is being referred to? Now, here in the story, here in the play, there was a sentence, then the situation changed. So what does this mean? Okay, what is being referred to means what it shows or what it wants to say. The situation changed after the transfer of the property. What does it mean? That what happened, that when first Juman was taking care of his aunt, but as soon as his aunt transferred all the property to Juman, okay, Juman forgot his promise that he will take care of aunt as long as she lives, and he and his wife began to ill-treat her. Okay, ill treat means they were not behaving with her, they were not behaving properly with her, and also they were not taking care of her, and also not giving food to her, were not willing to give food to her. Second question is, when Juman's aunt realized that she was not welcomed in his house, what arrangement did she suggest? Now, the second question says that Juman's aunt realized when they were quarreling, they started quarreling after a couple of years. Juman's wife and aunt started quarreling, and she realized that they are not behaving properly with her. Okay, and that she was not welcomed in his house means that she was not, they were not behaving with her properly, and they did not want to keep her anymore. Okay, so what arrangement she suggest? Arrangement means what did she suggest to Juman? What did she want it from Juman after that? When she came to know, or when she realized that Juman and his wife don't want to keep her with them anymore. So Juman's aunt could not bear the insult anymore. Now after, when she realized she did not want to take that insult anymore, and she wanted to cook her food for herself separately. Separately means by herself. Okay, she did not want to live with them anymore, and she wanted to set up a different separate kitchen for her. So she demanded, what arrangement she suggest? She demanded monthly allowance, or you can say monthly money she wanted from her nephew. Why? Because all the property which she belonged, all the property which she owned, she transferred it to her nephew. So she said that, give me monthly allowance. Third question is, what was Viraj's reaction when the aunt explained her case to them? Now, after that, aunt went to the villagers and she explained her case to them. And she was seeking their advice. She was seeking the support. For seeking the support, she went to the villagers. So what was the villagers' reaction? This question is asking. So the old woman went to several villagers, and when she explained their case to get the support, or you can say to support and advice, some showed sympathy, some laughed at her, and also some advised her to make it up with Juman, or you can say here it is written to make peace with Juman. In the book it is written to make it up with Juman or her nephew. It means to compromise. Fourth question is, why was Juman happy over Algu's nomination as head punch? Now it is very simple question, that it is asking that why Juman was very happy after he heard that Algu is going to be the head punch. So it says that Algu and Juman were very fast friends, very best friends. So Juman was expecting that Algu will definitely not go against him. And naturally he was feeling very happy because the head punch was his very best friend. So he thought that he will not give verdict, or you can say judgment, against him. The fifth question is, God lives in the heart of the punch, thus aunt said. What did she mean? Now what does this line means? It's because this line was said by aunt, that God lives in the heart of punch. What does this line means? This question is asking. The aunt meant that a person in seat of judge becomes fair and just. She says that she means that she after saying this, she mean wants to say, or she means that when a person is seated on the seat of, on the chair of judge, he becomes very fair and just. Okay, he becomes very fair and just like a God, because in front of God's eye, everyone is equal. So she also thinks that Punch is also a kind of a God who in front of whom everybody is equal, and he is not guided by his personal likes and dislikes. So as soon as the person sits on this sit on the seat of a judge, or you can say sit on the place of a head punch, he is not guided. He is not guided by his personal likes and dislikes. Okay, he has to keep his personal likings and dislikes away after sitting in this. So he says that, she says that he cannot do anything injustice because he is sitting on the fair and just place like the God. He is God representative. So once a person is sitting on the place of head punch, he is representing God. That's why, as in front of God's eye, everybody is equal. Head punch, whosoever is the head punch, everybody is equal in his eye also. Okay, now this is question number 5. The last question from this part is, what was Algu's verdict as head punch? Now, verdict means judgment, okay, or decision, you can say. So after hearing all the case and after discussing about with other punch also, what was his verdict? What decision he gave on this matter? How did Juman take it? And the second part of this question is, how did Juman take this verdict or judgment? Now Algu heard the case and he gave a fair judgment after, because Algu knew that who was wrong and who was right. So he gave the judgment after discussing with other panch also, and he asked Juman that either he has to pay the monthly allowance to his aunt, or what he will do, or he will transfer the property back to her. There were two options he gave to Juman, that either you give a monthly allowance to aunt or return her property back. Okay, so this was Algu's verdict on this matter. Now how did Juman take it? What was Juman's reaction after hearing this verdict? He was very upset. Why? Because he was not expecting this answer. He was not expecting this verdict, judgment, from his best friend. And he was very stunned. He was very shocked. And he became Algu's enemy. And also he decided to take revenge from Algu. Okay. So now this was the first part of your chapter Fair Play, written by Premchand. And I hope you have understood till here. In the next video, we are going to continue this chapter. Okay, till the next video, stay home, stay safe. Bye.